Hi, this is Eileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about the data preparation workflow for color printing. A typical workflow for color printing follows these steps: importing and conversion, fixing and shrink wrap, editing, texture editing, build preparation, and export to printing. Let's start with the import step. In order to print a part, you need STL files. If you have native CAD files, you first need to convert them into STL files. This is because STL files can tell the 3D printer where the inside and the outside part is, unlike CAD files. In color printing, two of the file formats you will encounter often are VRML and OBJ. While you're importing files with color and texture information, please make sure that you enable import colors and import textures. If you'd like to learn more about importing and converting files, please see our tutorial on importing. Next step is fixing errors in STL files. Errors can occur due to design imperfections or during the conversion from CAD to STL. Fixing is a crucial step to avoid build failures and to print high quality parts. For colored parts, shrink wrap is used often. This function will wrap your part with a 2D surface and shrink the surface around your part. You can apply local shrink wrap on a marked region. For example, these chimneys have bad edges as indicated by the yellow lines. And now we can see that the yellow lines are gone, thus the errors are fixed. You can also apply a global shrink wrap on a complete part. Let's click on apply. And here is our part, nicely fixed and free of errors. If you'd like to know more about shrink wrapping, please check our tutorial video on shrink wrap for color prints. You can also do manual fixing where necessary. For more information on fixing, please watch our tutorial video on fixing. A fixed file is ready to be edited and enhanced for printing efficiency and part performance, depending on the 3D printing technology you're using. For example, you can hollow your parts or add honeycomb structures to make them lighter, or cut large parts into smaller pieces if they're too big for your machine. You can even label your parts. If you'd like to learn more about editing and enhancing, please see our tutorial on editing files. In color printing, editing textures and colors is an important step. You can color triangles by marking them. Let's mark this surface. And from texture, we go to paint part, select the color, and click on color marked. You can directly edit a texture from the edit texture menu. Let's go to the textures list, select a texture, and you click on edit the selected texture. Here you can change the size, the position, and the orientation of your texture. You can also add a texture, for example a logo, on top of an existing texture. We can mark a region, go to new texture, select our texture or logo, and have it applied directly on the existing texture. Here again, we can change the size, the position, the rotation of your logo or texture. Let's click on apply. You can also edit this texture in your favorite image editor. For example, I changed the background color to black here. And I can go back to my texture, click on Update Textures, and my changes will be directly applied on the texture. You can also texturize details that are too small or risky to print. For example, this bench might be too small to print on a healthy scale. Then you can use the Part to Texture option. In the Part to Texture option, we specify the part to be texturized, and we also mark an area where we want the texturization to occur, and we indicate which part this is going to happen on. When we click on Apply, you see that an image of the bench has been created. If I just hide the bench, you can see now on the surface here, there is a texture representing the existing of the bench. Magics Essentials covers the first four steps of this workflow until build preparation. For the following steps, you will need to use the software delivered with your 3D printer. If you upgrade to Magics RP, you can run the whole workflow in one software up to slicing. If you combine Magics RP with a build processor specific to your machine, you can even do slicing and hatching directly from Magics RP. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.